By the end of this video, you'll understand how to create and use class diagrams to improve your software's architecture. Whether you're building your first app or optimizing enterprise level code, you're working on a huge app with multiple developers. Everyone's coding at the same time, and it feels like things are moving fast. But something's off. Code keeps breaking. Modules don't seem to fit together like they're supposed to. And every time you fix one thing, two more bugs pop up. It's like playing whack-a-mole with your own project. Why is everything falling apart? It's not about bad code. It's about missing the big picture. Everyone's working on their piece, but no one really understands how they all fit together. Like building a house where the plumbing doesn't connect to the sink, or the electrical system skips a room. That's what happens when there is no clear plan for your software's architecture. Without a plan, you're just patching code together, hoping for the best. You fix the symptoms, but not the root cause. Every time a new feature is added, it feels like pulling a thread that unravels everything else. Developers get frustrated, clients are annoyed. You're left wondering, how can I keep this project from spiraling out of control? Here's the thing. What you really need is a blueprint for your code, a way to see all the pieces interact before you even write them. This is where class diagrams come in. They allow you to map out the relationships, roles, and responsibilities of every part of your code. But for now, in this story, your project turns into a tangled mess. Deadlines get pushed. You spend more time fixing bugs than building features. But what if you had a class diagram to plan things from the start? Let's rewind. Same project, same developers, but this time, before anyone writes a single line of code, the team gathers around and draws out a class diagram. It's basically a map that shows all the classes in the system, their properties, methods, and how they relate to each other. What is a class diagram? Why is it so powerful? Here's the deal. A class diagram is part of UML, Unified Modeling Language, and it's a visual representation of your object-oriented design. It shows you not just what the classes do, but how they talk to each other. Think of it like a blueprint for a building. You wouldn't start construction without knowing where the walls go, right? Same with code. The real magic of a class diagram comes from its ability to show relationships. For instance, it tells you which classes control what, which classes does the heavy lifting, how data flows between them, inheritance or composition, whether a class depends on another or can stand on its own. You can map out associations where one class needs another, inheritance where one class extends another class's functionality, and dependencies when changes in one class affects another. For example, you might have a user class that interacts with a subscription class. The diagram will show you that user has a subscription. If your project adds more type of subscriptions later, like premium subscription, the diagram shows you how you'll need to modify the code. You're not just guessing where new features fit in. You can see it. That's the power of planning. With this diagram in place, your team can predict where issues might pop up before you even hit compile. You've got a bird's eye view of how every class behaves and interacts. It's like switching from a foggy map to GPS navigation. And when you do start coding, everything just works. Classes fit together like puzzle pieces because you've already thought about the design. It's easier to make changes, add features, and find bugs because you know exactly where to look. Best of all, you don't waste time reworking code that was doomed from the start. So whether you're building a tiny app or an enterprise-level system, class diagrams give you the blueprint you need to design cleaner, more maintainable software. They help you avoid messy code and broken relationships before they happen. Next time you're about to dive into a big project, take a step back and draw that class diagram first. It might just save your whole project.